I've been too long on my own. Everybody has a private world where they can be alone. Are you calling me? Are you trying to get through? Are you reaching out for me? I'm reaching out for you.
I'm just so depressed, I just can't seem to get out this slump. If I could just get over this hump, but I need something to pull me out this dump. I took my bruises, took my lumps, fell down and I got right back up. But I need that spark to get psyched back up in order for me to pick the mic back up. I don't know how or why or when I ended up in this position I'm in. I'm starting to feel distant again, so I decided just to pick this pen up and try to make an attempt to vent. But I just can't admit or come to grips with the fact that I may be done with rap. I need a new outlet, and I know some so hard to swallow, but I just can't sit back and wallow in my own sorrow. But I know one fact, I'll be one tough act to follow. One tough act to follow. I'll be one tough act to follow. Here today, gone tomorrow, but you'd have to walk 1,000 miles.
My shoes just to see what it's like to be me. I'll be you, straight shoes.
Tonight, the effects of bullying make another tragic mark. A 13-year-old girl took her own life over the weekend, and tonight her parents have a message for everyone.
She just couldn't realize that this could be handled and she could get over it and move on.
13-year-old Rachel Emke's parents aren't shy to talk about their daughter.
She developed into a wonderful personality. She was kind, loving, sincere, a helpful little girl that had big goals.
The suicide of a teenage girl in British Columbia is drawing attention tonight to the issue of bullying. Before she died, she chronicled online.
The video is heartbreaking. A 15-year-old named Amanda. She never speaks, but recounts how she descended into depression and self-harm after months of taunts online progressed to attacks at school. She uploaded it to YouTube last month. Yesterday, she took her own life.
Feel lonely. And I think that's why it's so critical that parents look for those warning signs and talk early and talk often about how their child's doing, asking direct questions about.